My name is Jill Marlowe, and this is my story. When I was in elementary school, I was that girl that played with Barbies. But mostly I was into building my Barbie houses. I was all about optimizing my Barbie dream house. I used to take it apart, rebuild it from parts of other things. Between that desire to build things, optimize things, and tweak things, and figuring out that I was really good at math and science, I kind of stumbled into engineering. I fell into engineering because I was good at math and science, and also because I think I grew up on the Chesapeake Bay sailing. Seeing the wind go over the sails and figuring out how to trim them and optimize, you know, how fast we were going. So when I went to school and went to engineering and had to choose which discipline, I chose aerospace. So the biggest influence on my life, I think, have been my parents. My dad grew up kind of on the wrong side of the tracks in Detroit and was self-made. He eventually went into the Navy and got himself on the GI Bill and put himself through college and worked very, very hard to kind of get to a place in life where we had a very comfortable upbringing. He was a great influence, always reminding us that if you work hard, you know, it will pay off. I was inspired to work for NASA because I was actually getting transplanted to the area. My husband was in the Navy up in New England at the time. He got assigned to a destroyer in Norfolk. And I was working on my master's degree and in one afternoon sent a bunch of resumes out. Got a cold call from a guy that eventually was my boss and my first mentor here at NASA. And by the end of the first conversation with him, I was totally intrigued. I just never thought I would work at NASA. But by the time we got done with that conversation, he invited me on a plant trip. Coming here and meeting the people and seeing the range of challenges that people were working on, spaceflight instruments, thinking about climate change, I mean, big stuff that mattered. I was sold. I wanted that job bad, and I eventually got the offer, and the rest is history. They cared about me as a person. NASA actually cares about people and about our interests and wants to tap the best in us. The biggest barrier in my career, you know, it's funny, I asked my husband about this just the other day. He had a very interesting insight. He said that I have, as a woman, probably tried very, very hard to prove myself. Felt like I had to prove myself, although nobody else is judging me in that way. And what he said is, I work at a crazy pace as a result. And I sometimes get frustrated with people maybe not keeping up or not working at the same pace. It's interesting because I've never had that insight at all. I just think about, you know, trying to do the best that I can every day. I think it goes back a little bit maybe to my father teaching me that you need to give 100%, and if you work hard, it'll pay off. And anything worth working for is worth giving your best toward. The happiest moment of my career, people tell all kinds of stories about launches of a big project. But I would say that my happiest moments are really when, you know, I'm working with a particular person and they're chewing on a problem and they cannot figure out how to solve it, and we'll sit down and have a conversation, and through that I can watch the wheels turn and they get unstuck. And it's just those little moments really that I feel like those are the times that that people will remember. My greatest accomplishment is probably the people that I've brought to the agency, and hopefully making that difference through them. I've been working in management for probably about 15 years at this point, and so I've had a fair amount of opportunity to hire some folks over the years, and I've watched those people move from the technical work that they've done. Sometimes they move into being subject matter experts that are sought out by people all over the world. Sometimes they're managing projects for NASA. But when I see those people doing things, great things, that I know that from talking to them when they came into this agency, they never saw themselves doing, that just makes me smile, warms my heart. I feel like a little bit like a mom. I think the most important lessons that I've learned in my life are: seize the opportunities when they present themselves. I couldn't have planned the career that I've had, the opportunities that have found me. NASA really, really values its people, and it's the people of NASA that makes things happen.